Part 2. How to generate keyword ideas using keyword research tools. There are quite a few awesome tools that help you study what people are searching for in Google. Let me cover a few of the most popular keyword research tools and explain how they work. So there's this tool called AnswerThePublic, which is quite popular among SEOs and content marketers, probably because of this highly charismatic dude on their homepage. No, I'm just kidding, that's a really neat free tool, seriously. Give it any word or phrase and it will return a list of relevant questions that people put into Google. For example, if I type cats into the search bar, it will give me almost 200 questions that contain the word cats. Can cats eat dog food? Where cats like to be pet? Which cats shed the least? Etc. You're probably wondering, how does this tool know what people are searching for? Well, the source of their data is very simple. It's Google's auto-suggest feature. If you start typing your question like can cats, it will immediately show you some popular searches. And if you start typing the next letter, it will give you suggestions based off this letter. That's where this little free tool gets their search queries. As stated on their homepage, they use auto-suggest feature in Google and Bing to give you keyword suggestions. Here's another similar tool that is based on Google auto-suggest feature. It's called UberSuggest. The difference between the two is that UberSuggest doesn't focus on questions. And all their keyword suggestions will start from your seed keyword, as you can see here. Everything starts with the word cats. Both of these tools don't show you the monthly search volume of the search queries they suggest, but you already know where to get it, right? Now on to the next keyword research tool, which you probably know already. It's called Google Keyword Planner and it's a part of AdWords, Google's advertising platform. This tool used to be the single best source of keyword ideas back in the days, but in recent years Google was taking more and more data away from SEO professionals. So today Google Keyword Planner is a great tool for advertisers that want to pay for traffic from Google, but not so much for SEO professionals who want to get free traffic from Google. And yet you can still get great keyword ideas from Google Keyword Planner. If I enter the word cats, I'll get a few hundred cool keyword ideas and the tool can even sort them into groups, which is rather handy and useful. The main downside is that you don't see monthly search volume of these keywords. You only see ranges, which are not super helpful. And if you want to see the actual numbers, you'll have to start an advertising campaign and put some money into it. But in any case, Google's own keyword research tool should not be ignored, even though they limit the data that you get for free. And finally, let's look at the keyword research tool that we have in Ahrefs. It's called Keywords Explorer and it runs on a monstrous database of 4.6 billion search queries. We use multiple sources of data to collect a database of this size, but the main one is Clickstream. In short, Clickstream data comes from a large group of mostly free apps that you install on your computer and give them permission to collect your browsing data, anonymize it, and aggregate into a huge Clickstream database. From this database, digital marketers can then learn what people search for online and which websites they visit, but there is no personal information on any of these people. Clickstream data is literally a rescue to the SEO community, as many amazing tools and features can be built on top of it. So back to Ahrefs Keywords Explorer. If I enter the same word cats, I'll get a list of almost a million search queries that contain the word cats in them. I guess when you compare this number of keyword suggestions to the number of keyword ideas in Google Keyword Planner, you'll see why SEO professionals are so mad at Google, right? But what do you do with a list of almost a million search queries? Well, remember the previous lesson where we talked about keyword difficulty? I said it's a great way to narrow down a huge list of keyword ideas to those where you don't need any backlinks to rank. So let's put 0 in KD filter and see what we'll get. When do cats stop growing? Can cats eat bread? Do male cats have nipples? These search queries could easily be answered with awesome blog articles. If I open the search results for Can Cats Eat Bread search query, I'll see that most of the top ranking articles get a few hundred monthly visits from search with almost no backlinks, which looks like a great opportunity to me. And that was a quick overview of how to use keyword research tools to get a ton of great keyword ideas to target on your blog. Just feed these tools with words and phrases related to your niche and examine the output. And don't forget what we've learned in lesson number 3. Always look at the total search traffic potential of the top ranking pages and how many backlinks they have. And please take action before you move to the next strategy. Go play with the tools that I've just mentioned and see how many awesome article ideas you'll be able to find.